Welcome back everyone to another video, it's Andy here. Now ever since I did my first alternate build from Rebrickable.com, I have fell in love with alternate builds. You soon realize there are many ways to build a Lego set other than what it was designed for, so you get more fun out of it. There are many creative minds out there, and the credit of this build I'm going to show you goes by a name of TimeHH on Rebrickable.com, so thank you for that. It's a magnificent heavy-duty truck and trailer, and it's an alternate build to Technic Set 42098, the car transporter. Let's go see how great this build is. You gotta see it to believe it. This is the heavy-duty truck and trailer by TimeHH. I have to say, this thing is a beauty. It stands out for two things, I say. One, the bright red color. Makes the set really pop. I think if you mix some blue on the tractor, you might get some Optimus Prime vibe. And two, the length. It's really long, the trailer. That's the main reason why I chose this build. The longer, the better. I believe that's how it looks so epic. Up on the front here, the doors on both sides do open and close. The side mirrors here, you can adjust it to your desire. I believe it was designed the same way as the original set. I like how these two antenna pieces are added. It makes the tractor design look so much more better than the original. There is a switch down here. If I flip it down, as you can see, the front tilts forward. And if I flip it back, it comes right back up. In order to steer, there's this knob here. You just turn it left and right. Now, and to separate the trailer from the tractor is very easy. All you have to do is lift it up, and there you go. It's all separated. And to attach it again, you have this yellow piece down here. All you have to do is put it into the gap down there. And there you have it. It's all attached again. Just to take a quick look back here, if I lift this up and I roll it back and forth, there you can see the gears are turning. And that's really cool. Moving on to the trailer, if you ask me about the building technique, I say it's divided into three sections. We have this middle part right down the middle here. Then we have these two platform pieces that were built separately and then attached onto it afterwards. One thing I would say for the middle part, it required a lot of Technic pins in order to assemble the pieces together. Here we have a knob here, and this sets down the landing gear as I'll show you right now. I just turn it left. Then it sets down. If I turn it the other way, it comes back up again. So that's another cool feature. Giving you an idea of what I meant, here is one step in the instructions. This is the middle part I pointed out earlier. If you look over here, see if I can focus it. There are 39 pins here, 39 pins alone in one step. I have never built a Technic set that required 39 pins in one go. When I finished building it or assembled it, I counted 38 pins. I double checked and triple checked, and I was having trouble finding where that last pin went until I came down over here. There was that last pin on the inside part, not on the outside. So that was an interesting part of the build. In the back here, we have this part that moves back and forth. I'm not 100% sure what's it for, but the more I played around with it, I'm guessing it's providing a pathway for whatever is being loaded onto the trailer so it doesn't roll onto the tires. If there are truck drivers or truck enthusiasts out there, can you confirm or deny my guess for me? That would be appreciated. The tires back here is interesting. As you notice, there are two different rims. These two are from the car transporter truck, whereas this one is from the blue car of the original set. And of course, we have the ramp that does come down and up again. My favorite feature out of this whole build. Now, if there's one thing you may want to know is this build did not use all the pieces from the set. In fact, if you look here, these are all of my remaining pieces, and it is a lot. I'm going to guess this is about one third of what is left. There are certainly a good amount of Tekkik pins left, and these are those guardrail pieces on top of the car transporter from the original set, and they certainly weren't used at all. Honestly, you can't enjoy this set to the fullest without placing something on the trailer. This was meant to carry something like a bulldozer or some kind of heavy machinery, but I don't have anything like that. Obviously, I can't fit the Bugatti on it. It's because it's too big and wide, not fit to its scale, and I glanced to my left. No way. Uh-uh. No way! Yes way. Oh man. I just have one word for this. Epic. Oh snap. I have to be honest, this idea came totally by accident before I even made this video. As I almost finished building the trailer, I looked at my space shuttle thinking to myself, if this might fit on it, it appears to be long enough. I even thought it may be too long and won't fit on it, but just look at that. It's practically the same length. It's like it's meant to be. Of course, the designer never in the world imagined this, neither did I. This, of course, defies reality as it can never happen. A space shuttle is way too heavy for a trailer like this to sustain that kind of load. This was totally done just for fun and entertainment. I was trying to remake that moment in 2012 when the shuttle Endeavor was traveling on the streets of Los Angeles, making its way to the California Science Center. It was a two-day journey from the airport to there. I read an article online saying it traveled on a 160-wheeled carrier. So a truck and trailer like this certainly was not possible. I wish I was there to witness it. Definitely would have been a breathtaking moment. Even the load right now is too much. If I try to roll it, it's very hard because the shuttle, even a model, is too heavy now. So I'm probably going to take this off now so won't do any kind of damage to either set. So I'm going to put down my camera and I'll be right back. So overall, I say this is definitely a fantastic build. Thank you again to TimeHH for providing the instructions. If you have the Tekkik car transporter set and want to give this build a try, I'll provide you a link in the description so you can download the instructions from the source. I am beyond satisfied. This is why I love Tekkik. I know Tekkik is not everyone's cup of tea. Some might find it too challenging for them or not having the patience for it. The building techniques are complex. That's totally fine. For myself, I find it challenging for me, and that's where I get my satisfaction. The final products are so good. Just look at this build or the Bugatti. Makes the money you paid for it and the time it took for you to build well worth it. Do you like Tekkik? If not, what type of theme are you more into? Let me know in the comments as I like to read through them, and I'm also curious. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up so other folks like you can also enjoy epic builds like this. Subscribe to the channel, remember, for more alternate builds as I expect to do more down the road now since they're so fun, and much more other content to come. And turn on that notification bell so you won't miss it. I shall conclude it here. Thank you for watching. See you next time, and in the meantime, keep on building. Epic builds. I think I'm gonna keep it like this for a while.